Evening, folks. We'll get started in a bit. Let us continue.
While Carl was about to finally make it back home, Freddy was joining the Canadian troops stationed at Vimy. In the sky, George, a British aviator from the Royal Air Force, was spotting the German positions for artillery support. On this day, Canadian troops led the charge.
I did those last time. All right, let's continue. Five. see if there's anything worth finding over here. So a Canadian soldier got about 30 dollars and 30 cents a month, if my math is right on that. No, 1.1, so they got about $33 a month, it looks like. I wanted the tank. I was not expecting to get squashed by my own guy. This is why you give me the tank, so I... Dumbass.
And sacrifices, the Canadians finally managed to take the hill back from the Germans. The United States' entry into the war grew more certain by the week. The last letter from Freddie's younger brother confirmed his country's newfound eagerness to join the fight. Carl was within a few hundred yards of Emile's farm when the rumbling of the French air patrols began thundering through the April sky.
Doggo! Alright, first we'll look at the diary since there only seems to be one in there. April 9th, 1917. You've been spared this madness. The whole world's gone crazy. Even my younger brother wants to enlist. I have talked some sense into him. He has no idea of the hellfire and damnation going on here. It was a glorious victory today with my Canadian comrades, but at what price? Go ahead and pull up the historical facts. Only one of them again.
rockets!
Ugh.